Some interesting stuff to talk about in the tropics, guys. They are still pretty active. We are already on to the end storm, which is Nana. That is the next storm, and we have two areas in the Atlantic we're watching. Pretty impressive wave, it looks like, just to the south of the DR and Haiti as well. But in the near term, we actually have this, and it's expected to become Tropical Depression 15. Jess will have more coming up in the next hour as the track gets released for that. It will be south of us, but this could become Nana or this too. So the tropics still quite active, and we'll be watching them for you. Closer to home this afternoon, just some high clouds down in Kittery and Portsmouth, but it's somewhat cool, especially along the coastline with the sea breeze that's kicked in, and that's moved all the way in for inland to Sanford, where it's only 69 right now, 64 in Wiscasset and Rockland, where it's 71 in Augusta and Waterville. The air is nice and dry too, and a lot of times on a clear night, the dew points can be an indication of how low the temperatures will go. So I do think a lot of us will end up in the 40s overnight tonight. Clouds, just some fair weather ones earlier today. Now there's a little bit of a thicker band of clouds to our south that may move through southern Maine tonight, but all of this rain will miss us to the south. We're waiting on this frontal system to the west. That will come in Wednesday into Thursday with our next chance for a couple showers and storms. So tonight, a partly cloudy, comfortable night, dipping into the 40s in a lot of northern Maine, even some of the western valleys down into the 40s too, dropping to about 54 in Portland and 58 in Biddeford. Tomorrow, basically a repeat, partly sunny, temperatures again getting into the low and mid 70s. Some coastal towns like Rockland, Owl's Head, Thomaston may stay in the 60s, but I think Portland should hit 72 before the sea breeze kicks in tomorrow afternoon. Hour by hour, you can see that here. Some clouds mixing in middle of the day tomorrow, so we'll call it a partly sunny day, and then there's the sea breeze in the afternoon, cooling down the coastline. Now tomorrow night, it's a little milder. Temperatures, it'll be in the 50s, and then Wednesday, I think we have more clouds, but a lot of the time it will be dry on Wednesday. Just a chance for a shower or two in the afternoon. That's as this front comes in, and then we get into the warmer air on Thursday. Should be up to around 80. Friday looks like the warmest day in the forecast. Could be into the mid 80s. And then for the holiday weekend, high pressure builds in, and it looks like this will be a pretty big sprawling high that sets up over us during the weekend. So I know it's only Monday, but the news is good about the upcoming weekend. At this point, it looks like we'll have temperatures in the 70s all 3 days, maybe a shower or storm on Labor Day itself. Seas running 2 to 3 feet tomorrow, a southeast wind 5 to 10 knots. And the 7 day shows kind of the temperature roller coaster we're on here. 70s the next 2 days, back into the 80s Thursday, and especially Friday. That looks to be the warmest day. Then over the weekend, the sun returns, but it also cools back down. Saturday and Sunday, probably a lot like today. Little sea breeze, temps into the 70s. And low humidity. So